Concussions.
Marshall is totally true, because my sisters are still on Instagram and they're like, oh, did you see so-and-so's post? My mom, no, I didn't. Tell me what it said.
Okay, so my topic is concussions. So what a concussion is, according to the CDC, is a traumatic brain injury that happens when you bump, blow, or jolt your head, and your brain kind of shakes in your skull, and it can stretch, and it can twist, and it causes chemical changes in your brain. And so I like this picture because it kind of shows the brain moving around in your head. So I have personal stories with concussions. I actually had 3 in less than a year, and it was all caused from playing girls lacrosse. So the first one was, it was before a game, it was my freshman year, and I was practicing, but we weren't able to use the field, so we had to play on this small patch of grass, and it was like sort of like cement around it. And I was passing the ball with one of my teammates, and I missed the ball, and I had to go run after it, and I was wearing cleats, and I slipped, and I slammed my head on the cement. And I didn't realize how bad of an injury it was, and so I played in the game. And so my next one was, I was in the middle of the game, and my teammate was passing the ball to me, and I didn't realize how close the ball was actually coming towards me, and it smacked me in the head. And I was so embarrassed, and my goggles knocked off my head, and the ref pulled me off the field, and I didn't play for the rest of the game. And then my third concussion happened. I passed out, and I smacked my head on the counter and on the floor, and it was because I had low blood pressure, and it was because I was super healthy, and it's normal for teenage girls to pass out from being healthy and playing sports. So my idea with concussions is that we need to change and bring awareness to how serious concussions can be. They can cause major brain damage. In my personal experience, I've noticed that I've had a hard time with memory loss. I don't really remember things. I used to have like a really good memory, but now I've noticed that I have a hard time remembering simple things. Another thing is that we need to learn how much of an impact they can make on our lives. Like I said, they can cause permanent damage that can really affect your everyday life. And we need to take them more seriously instead of ignoring them, because a lot of people, especially in the NFL, coaches tell people to lie and say that they're fine and jump right back into the game, which is not safe because it can prolong the concussion and make it worse and cause permanent damage. So my evidence is an article, Brain Changes Persistent Student Athletes 6 Months After. This article kind of talks about how there have been major studies and like a lot of studies about how people are still experiencing concussions even after 6 months of having one, and it can be really difficult to do simple tasks like getting up, waking up for school and going to school, and imagine going to school with a constant headache and sensitivity to light. And so that's what people are experiencing when they don't take care of themselves and take it seriously. And then in the article, Concussions Are No Fun, this kind of talks about how people overexert themselves and, like I said, kind of hide it and jump right back into the game because they don't want to miss out on helping their teammates, and a lot of coaches say just to pretend like they don't have it. And then with this image, I really like how it kind of shows the healthy side of the brain versus when you have a traumatic brain injury. And each of the colors are kind of different parts of the brain and what they do with a healthy brain versus when you have a traumatic brain injury. And my call to action is, I think we need to make sure that we have safer precautions. Like this picture kind of shows girls lacrosse wearing helmets. And from my personal experience, helmets were not required, and they still aren't required in my sports. It's more of an option, and I think we need to change that because we want to prevent more concussions or less concussions in teenagers. to improve technology and make change to sports. I don't know how long it will be till they do that, but that's what I know, that they're trying to make changes.
How long does it take to heal from a concussion?
I think it depends on each person. Usually a lot of people only wait like a week, which is fine, but I think if you want to be able to play the sport and continue to play the sport and heal all the way, I think you need to take more time. And you can kind of go based off of what your doctor